I'm going to show you how to make the Doctor Strange effect using PowerDirector and some of my favorite video effects from big films. Links to the video effects I use in this tutorial are in the video description. Let's get mystical. I have a clip of an individual moving and waving his arms all over the place to make a spell like Doctor Strange. First thing that we need to do is add the Magic Swirl to the scene. So I'm going to go up here to the Ignite clip. I'm going to hold down my left mouse button and I'm going to drag it down to the beginning of the clip on track 2. Now I'm going to double left click on this clip. You want to move your playhead to a position where you can see some of the swirl going on. And you want to place the swirl on his hand. You can use the crosshairs here. Place your mouse over the crosshairs until you see these crosshair arrows. Hold down your left mouse and you can drag it where you need it to be. Now, I already know where I want it to be, so I'm just going to type in the parameters, change the scale, all those good things. And now I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And next we need to brighten up the effect and add some backlight to it so that we got more light showing on the individual's face coming from the swirl. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Fix Enhance. We're going to go to Light Adjustment and we'll click that. We'll go ahead and click on OK. We're going to add some backlight. And then we're going to go ahead and move the light all the way up to 100. And now we'll go ahead and close this out. And if we go ahead and play this, you see the little swirl going on when he moves his hands. Now we want to add the first mandala. So we're going to move our playhead to a position where we want to go ahead and bring the mandala down. We're going to go up here to Mandala 2. We'll hold down our left mouse button and we'll drag this right down to the playhead and we'll drag it down to track 3. And now we're going to trim this to fit the length of the clip. We'll hold our cursor at the end of this clip until we see two arrows pointing in the opposite direction. Hold on our left mouse button and we'll drag this in to trim it. Now we're going to double left click to open up the PIP designer for this mandala. And we're going to move our playhead to a position where we want to start the effect because we're going to need to animate this. So we're going to add a position keyframe and we're going to add a scale keyframe. For the position, you can go ahead and drag it to the position that you want it at. And you can scale it up by using the nodes. I'm going to go ahead and type in the parameters that I want because once again, I know exactly where I want it. Now we're going to move our playhead to the end of this clip. And when we move it there, we can see that the hand moved a little bit. So we want to go ahead and move the mandala to stay over the hand. So at this point, we're going to go ahead and you can drag it over to the position that you want once again. But what I'm going to do is go ahead and add in the position and the scale that I want to use. And I'm making it a little bit bigger because the camera was moving in closer, so it should make it a little bit bigger at this point. So now if we go ahead and play this back, we should see the mandala appear and then it'll follow his hand across the screen. Now we need to tilt the mandala because the guy's hands are at a bit of an angle and we want the mandala to match that. So we're going to move our playhead to a position where the mandala is on the screen. We can see it pretty well. And that's good right there. And now we want to go ahead and click on keyframe. We want to click on clip attributes. And we want to scroll down until we come to the freeform section. Now, to twist this in, we're going to go ahead and change the top left position. So we're going to do 0.015 and hit enter. And you see it tilts back a little bit. Then we're going to change the bottom left position so that it matches. And hit enter. And so you see it twisted in here. Now, what we'll do is we'll go ahead and move our playhead to the beginning. And we'll add a keyframe here as well. And we'll right click on it. And we're going to choose duplicate from next keyframe. So that this way it stays twisted all the way through. And we can even just get rid of this keyframe if we need to. So now it's twisted at an angle. Looks a lot better. Gives it some more depth. We're good to go. So I'm going to go ahead and close this out. Now we need to brighten this up and add some backlight to it as well. So we'll go to Fix Enhance. We'll go to Lighting Adjustment. We'll add the backlight. And we'll brighten it up. And we'll close this out. Now we can go ahead and add the second mandala the same way that we added the first one. And now we'll go ahead and play this back. This doctor is getting a little strange up in here. If you need more Marvel madness in your life, you can learn how to make a Marvel intro right here. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe. Hit me up with your comments. Use the link to grab those big films effects. And drop me a like down below.